What you want, baby, I got it. What you need, you know I got it. All I'm asking is for a little respect when you get home. Aretha Franklin got it right. How many of you can honestly say that you are happy in your love relationships? Those of you who are, keep doing what you're doing, keep enjoying it, and feel free to share your experience down in the comments. Let's see what we can do to help those who are not quite there yet because of how they're treated by their partner. Love and partnership are not just about how you view your partner, but also how you view yourself through your partner's eyes. And this can affect your self-esteem and mental health. Love is beautiful, but it is rarely straightforward. Certain challenges in love come to some people who want to hold on to something that has run its course, and the couple had already given each other everything there was to give each other. Or vice versa, people cut the relationship short before they really get to know each other and before they learn how to share their space and time with someone else, how to compromise, how to say no when necessary, when to be strong for each other, and when to open up and reveal their vulnerable side as well. And there are also relationships where love is mixed with other intents or interests such as convenience, habit, comfort, codependency, social conformity, and even materialism or need for supremacy and control. Depending on people's preferences, some of these things might manifest to a different degree at one stage or another in some relationships. But when these things are clearly not what you want and they do affect your self-esteem and mental health, you may want to change your course of action. To start with, always pay attention to red flags early on in the relationship, but also keep in mind that other people also have their own past fears and hurtful experiences, and they may need some time to open up. The early stages of a relationship are particularly important for setting healthy boundaries and expectations through clear but loving communication, free of demands and judgment. While passion and intimacy can ignite the relationship at the start, knowing what can upset the other person or make them happy, respecting each other and looking in the same direction becomes more and more important as the time passes. And clear boundaries and expectations right from the start help both partners learn those things without having to be mind readers. So, how can you distinguish between a person who needs more time to open up and someone whose red flags are not to ignore early in the relationship? The former may seem distant and reserved at first, but when you provide them with a safe and judgment-free environment, they relax and they start involving you more and more in their life, and they share more with you as well. You may even feel their happiness and gratitude to have you in their life. On the other hand, early red flags include all plans that a person makes which involve an element of how you will make their life easier or better. For example, how you will make their house or apartment cozier, cleaner, warmer, how you will take care of them like a parent or a close relative, how you will present them to social circles or experiences that they have always wanted access to, how having you by their side will improve their public image, and how you will save them taxes or provide them with financial support. They may not say this explicitly, but pay attention to where their additional effort goes. If they have researched or asked around about your family and background, and if they have drawn financial plans detailing your role in them, it means they have invested time and thought in this beforehand. And especially if they're all affectionate and don't leave you out of their side or company when you are both in your social circle, but they're more eager to be with their friends than keep you company when you're both in their social circle, you have a role in their lives other than just to be loved and to love. Be particularly careful with people who, for some reason, have not received much attention from other men or women before they met you. If, after meeting you, they're focused on you, and especially if they are ready to do a lot for you, it means that they're happy to have you in their life. However, if they're just happy that someone at all is attracted to them, and if they start pursuing others who had not paid attention to them before, then you are merely their self-esteem boost, not their choice. Don't be with someone simply because they have no other choice. You deserve to be their choice and priority right from the start, and you deserve to be loved and happy. If your partner does not want to go to public places with you and promises to involve you in the rest of their life, but doesn't keep this promise, you are very likely to be their booty call. The same goes for partners who brag in front of others about moments of intimacy with you. That should be private. If you really love this person and you are a risk taker, there are ways how to manage all this, because most people have their good side that can be brought out of them with the right treatment. But if the other person is crossing the line, here's how you can neutralize some major manipulation tactics of theirs. If they have requirements that you should fulfill in order to enjoy some sort of treatment from them, and you can sense that these requirements are not just for your own good. For example, when they promise to spend more time with you and give you more affection if you make more money or lose more weight or dress differently or if you are more provocative or more submissive in your behavior. Instead of questioning your self-worth and rushing to meet these conditions, be visibly surprised that there is a condition at all. In this way, instead of allowing them to make you feel uncomfortable, you challenge the existence of their requirements in the first place, and you question their judgment indirectly but firmly. If you give in and start worrying that maybe they're right about what you should change in yourself before you are treated well or to continue to be treated well, you lower your standards and give them permission to manipulate you and possibly use you. As I mentioned in my previous video, many times it is not the final result of your efforts that they're after. It is your effort itself that makes them feel important because you seek their approval or validation. As a result, they will most likely not give you their full approval or gratitude, and they will make you strive for that little bit more that they need from you. Another thing that may be helpful to address early on is what I call the joint expectations. For example, if your partner tells you, "I have done this for you, so now you can close your eyes and keep quiet about that other thing that I'm doing." In response, you may want to let them know that those two things are not related and you would be grateful for their integrity throughout their actions towards you. While compromise is key for any relationship to survive, it should come naturally without being expected, imposed, or used as a lever of control. What's important to point out here is that they wouldn't be voicing such expectations if they knew that you can act on your disapproval of their actions. They could forget that you can act on your disapproval if it has taken too long for you to express this disapproval. And when you finally give way to those pent-up emotions, you may be accused of being vengeful and depriving your partner of the chance to defend themselves because they don't remember details of what had happened so long ago. This doesn't mean that you should nag at them immediately for every little thing they did wrong, but if you want to discuss things that are worth mentioning, you may want to do it in a timely manner and with balanced emotion. Balanced emotion might also help you when you express gratitude towards your partner. Your appreciation will not be mistaken for dependence on your partner if whatever you are receiving seems like something that you have already come across or even something that you're used to, not something that only your partner can give you access to. So express gratitude with dignity, without bending over backwards for your partner. You don't owe them anything, just like they don't owe you anything either. Your knowing your self-worth and carrying yourself with dignity shouldn't pose a risk to your partner's ego and to the relationship. So if they act like it does, and if they try to play with your emotions and fears, help them realize that they are not your only source of happiness, even if they are the higher income earner and if a lot depends on them. That's right, even then. They are less likely to get bored with someone who has a life of their own and who is less predictable and easy to control, and they are more likely to keep trying to regain your appreciation and praise, which you would give your partner anyway from time to time. So it is a matter of finding the right balance between push and pull, push and pull. But if they're not there when you need them the most, if they waste your time and never make you a priority, if you're expected to wake up at 4 a.m. and cook for them before you go to work, if they threaten you with divorce because they have been caught red-handed, if you share them with something else or someone else who also takes away from your family's resources that are supposed to help your children's future. Collect your heart's pieces, collect your thoughts, sort out your finances as much as possible and get out of there. And never ever forget to love yourself. If you are getting value now, please like, share, subscribe and hit that bell button to get notified when I post a new video. Check out my other videos and let me know down in the comments if you would like to hear more on this topic or any other topics, because I care about what's important to you.